Hi there, it's a pleasure to welcome you to this basic course on number theory. Number theory is that branch of mathematics which deals with properties of integers. So we all know the positive integers, these are the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on. So these are the numbers you could count if you had enough fingers at hand. And then there are the negatives of these integers, the minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5 and dot dot dot. And we have the number 0, we have the integer 0. So all these together constitute the set of integers for us. Now we all also know that the set of integers has two basic structures defined on that, which are these structure of addition and the structure of multiplication. So with respect to addition, the set is clearly closed, which means that if you take any two integers, then their addition is again an integer. If you were to take 5 and minus 3, you add them, you are going to get 2, which is clearly an integer. If you were to take 7 and 5, you are going to get 12, which is also an integer. So the set of integers is closed. Undertaking addition, there is the number 0, which is actually the identity as far as addition is concerned. That means if you take any integer n and add 0 to it, you are going to get your n back, nothing is going to happen to it. Further, you have the negative of any integer, that means if you take any n, there is the minus n with the property that the sum of these two is going to give you 0. There is the associativity property. So all these properties are put in one box which is labeled group structure. So the set of integers is a group with respect to addition. There is also the operation of multiplication, which is very interesting, because while the set of integers is closed, undertaking multiplication, if you multiply any two integers, you are going to get integer. Whether it's 0 or non-zero, it doesn't matter. You may take 20, 20 and multiply by 0, you are going to get 0, but 0 is an integer after all. You have the identity, the 1, which when multiplied to any n, will give you that n back. And of course, there is associativity. If you have 3 integers, you multiply them in any order, you multiply A to B and then to this product you multiply by C, or you keep A as it is, first obtain BC and then obtain A into BC, you are going to get the same result. But things get interesting when we come to the question of division. Now, to an integer, if you wanted to divide by any integer, then it's not possible while remaining in the set of integers. I know some of you may be thinking that you cannot divide by 0. While that is true, but you know, even if I take a non-zero integer, suppose I wanted to divide 2 by 5, I will get some number which will be called 2 by 5. Somebody may call it 4 by 10. There is some number, but it's not an integer. That's what I mean by saying that the set of integers is not closed under taking divisions. So you cannot divide a given integer by any other non-zero integer. However, the division is sometimes possible. You can divide 10 by 2. You can divide 20, 20 by 20. You can divide 20, 20 by 101. So sometimes division is possible, and this throws up a very interesting concept called the concept of a prime integer. Let me just give you the definition. A prime integer or a prime number for us is that positive integer which has exactly two positive divisors. So 1 is not a prime by our definition, and it's not considered to be prime. 1 has only one divisor, namely 1. No other positive integer is going to divide 1. And when we say division, we want to remain in the set of positive integers. So 4 is not a prime because 1 divides 4, 2 divides 4 and 4 divides 4. So it has 3 divisors. For a prime, we need only 2 divisors. So 2 is a prime. 3 is a prime, 5 is a prime, 7 is a prime, 11, 13, 17, 19, 23, 29, 31, 37. There are lots of prime numbers. Do the prime numbers go all the way up to infinity? Are there infinitely many primes? Are there infinitely many primes of the form 4n plus 1? 4n plus 1 means these are those numbers which, when divided by 4, leave the remainder 1. Are there infinitely many primes of the form 6n plus 5? These questions and many other interesting questions are going to be studied in this course. While we will prove that there are infinitely many prime numbers, we will give some sort of an idea for 4n plus 1, 4n plus 3. We will not be able to do the general case which is called the Dirichlet's theorem on infinitude of primes in arithmetic progressions. But we will study some of these very basic properties. We will also try to determine the set of primes which are sums of two squares, the set of primes P, which can be written as m square plus n square. For instance, 5 is a prime which is 1 square plus 2 square. 17 is a prime which is 1 square plus 4 square. 37 can be written as 1 square plus 36, 6 squares, 36. 13 can be written as 9 plus 4, 3 square plus 2 square. Whereas 3 is not a sum of 2 squares, 7 is not a sum of 2 squares, 11 is not a sum of 2 squares, and so on. 19 is not a sum of 2 squares. We will explicit 2 is a sum of 2 squares, 1 square plus 1 square. So, we will explicitly determine the set of primes which are sums of 2 squares, and of course, the remaining ones will be the elements which cannot be written as sums of 2 squares. So, these and many other basic properties of integers, mainly the properties of prime numbers, will be studied in this course. What is the adjective basic there? So, by basic, I mean that we are going to use basic mathematics to study these. There is, of course, the branch of number theory called algebraic number theory, where we use field theory, Galois theory, and so on to understand number theory. There are the analytic number theory things, which are the ones where we use complex analysis, contour integration, and so on, these things to study number theory. But here we are going to use basic things like counting, divisibility, and some very basic group theory techniques will be used. Other than that, advanced mathematical tools will not be used. However, let me warn you that this is not going to be an easy course. It's going to be an interesting course, that I can promise, but it's not going to be easy. You will have to work very hard to understand and learn this course. I will try to help in every possible way. My name is Shripad Garge. I teach mathematics at IIT Bombay. I am going to run this course with the help of my teaching assistants. I hope you will join this course, enroll for this course, and let's have a fun ride together. Thank you very much.